So thank you all for being here today. I'm very excited to be at this wonderful, beautiful, very important event. And I know the Loma Linda staff has worked tirelessly to create such a beautiful, beautiful event. And so I'm really honored to be part of it today. My name is Kate Garland, and I am a yoga teacher of 15 years and a yoga therapist. I have my own boutique yoga studio in Monrovia, California, with a private yoga therapy practice in addition to that, all in Monrovia, which is just about 25 minutes or so west of here, so not too far away. And so who here has practiced yoga ever in some form before? Yeah, so most everyone by this time, 2015, has practiced yoga in some form. It may have been back in college, it may have been in a gym. So most of you have some experience with yoga, and so you might be saying, Kate, what's a yoga therapist, right? So in yoga therapy, that's working with an individual, usually one-on-one, sometimes in a small group class setting, and drawing from a much larger toolbox than the yoga poses, the asana we call them in Sanskrit, the yoga poses, the postures that have really, unfortunately, become synonymous with yoga, right? Because I say yoga and you say pretzel, right? And that's a problem. And the media, of course, has really helped portray that in our Western modern world, we've taken this ancient healing modality that is yoga, or I even like to think of yoga really as a comprehensive self-care system. That's what yoga is to me. Yoga is a comprehensive way for me to take care of myself, thus take care of my family, my friends, my students and clients, right? But in the West, we've taken yoga and we've turned it into just a workout. We've turned it into yoga booty ballet. And there's a place for that, don't get me wrong. But to say that that's all yoga is, that yoga is a sport, that yoga is competitive, that yoga is just about the body, is really not correct and true to the essence of what really yoga is. So the yoga poses are great, right? There's nothing wrong with the yoga poses. They're actually a really small part of what yoga as this comprehensive self-care system really is. And so my personal mission in life is to try to overturn that misnomer a little bit about, you know, yoga just being about the body, yoga just being about taking my leg and wrapping it behind my head, right? Because trust me, I've done it. There's no personal fulfillment in it. It's not going to bring you more joy. It's not going to make your relationships better. It's actually not going to help your health. Okay, I can attest to that. It gave me a very deep hip injury. So there you are. So when I work with a client, yes, we may do the yoga poses, absolutely, but we're also going to use breathing techniques, and we're also going to use relaxation exercises, and we're going to do some sort of meditation appropriate for that student or some guided visualization. And we'll do maybe sound. We might use chanting or more likely mantra, just positive affirmations that we say to kind of reprint that negative script in our head a little bit. And we'll do what many people call lifestyle modification, right? If we want to change, we're going to have to change, right? So sometimes there's tweaking that needs to go on in our lifestyle. And I might do relationship counseling, and I'll do what I kind of broadly call lifestyle life skills reeducation. And so that's what I do when I teach yoga. So you might think that when I found essential oils, which was about 2 years ago, that I was just adding to this already very rich toolbox that I have, and that's not the case. The reality, unfortunately, is that I had a very severe and chronic odor problem in my yoga studio that shall go unnamed today since we're recording. But let's just say it was bad, and it was very much changing the ambiance and the energy of my studio. It was a very stressful business time for me. And I was either using natural things that just weren't working, or I was recommended to use some synthetic agents that I just refused to use. I just refused to bring chemicals into the studio. And so this went on, unfortunately, for months, I'll be honest. Summer came, it got hotter, it got worse, and it just happened to stumble across these therapeutic grade essential oils. And I was like, thank you, God. This is the answer to my prayers. And I brought a diffuser in, and I brought essential oils, and it immediately cleared the air. It made the entire space feel different, feel better, and my problems were solved. I was overjoyed, to be honest. So you might think that then I started to add essential oils into my yoga therapy practice, but no, I did not. I did, though, start tinkering with them at home a little bit. So my husband used to have very chronic acid reflux. So I would take this little bottle called a blend called Digestin, and I would rub just a little bit on his chest where he had the discomfort. And we had amazing success with that. And my daughter, who was only 3 months at the time, had her first diaper rash. And so I would try a little melaleuca and lavender and put that on her. And I was amazed how the rash was gone in a matter of hours. Just one application was all it took. And then if I would have a headache, I would experiment with a little lavender and peppermint and frankincense and put that on my temples and the back of my neck. And I was amazed at how headaches would be gone in, ready for it? Seconds. So you might think that then I started to bring essential oils into my yoga therapy practice, and I didn't. I didn't really ever intend to do it. It just happened so organically. I found myself just reaching for bottles at the studio with clients without really giving it a second thought, because essential oils and yoga are natural companions. They were meant to be together. Because think about it. What is, those of you who've practiced yoga, which is most of you, what is an essential component of yoga? What makes yoga yoga? I would say it is the most essential component of yoga. Breathing. Right. Right? And then think of now essential oils, or maybe a term you're more familiar with, which is aromatherapy, right? Who thinks they've ever had an aromatherapy experience before? Yeah, again, half or most of us, right? So maybe it was with essential oils, maybe it was with a scented candle, or a lavender-scented eye pillow, or some incense, maybe even at church or a religious ceremony. Maybe it was your grandmother's apple pie, right? Because really, all aromatherapy means is using your nose and your sense of smell to have a healing experience, right? And that's what aromatherapy is. But what's a prerequisite for that? Breathing, right? You can't smell something if you don't take, hopefully, a nice deep inhalation. So see, taking yoga and mixing essential oils together with them is just, it's a no-brainer. They were just meant to be together. They're just natural partners. And so I started using them more and more in my practice and started having really, really wonderful results. And there's something synergistic that happens when you use essential oils and the breath together, which is the two are more powerful, more potent when used together than when you use them individually on their own. So, to be honest, the essential oils that you have in your hands today really go way beyond just traditional aromatherapy. They certainly can be used for that reason, but there's much more to them as that than that. There's several other ways we can use them, and we'll just kind of touch on that today. But that's my hope, is that we're going to have an essential oils experience today using some tried and true tools of yoga, mainly breathing techniques, right? So before we get started, let me just talk briefly about essential oils. I want you to remember, because I bet both of you already know this, I want you to really remember that there's lots of room up front. Come on up. I smell good. I have lots of essential oils on me today. Essential oils are not old. Essential oils are not new. They're very, very old, right? Very, very old. They've been used for hundreds, if not thousands of years, because plants were man's first medicine. Yes? Way before we had a pharmaceutical lab, we had plants. And essential oils come from live plants. They are the roots, the flowers, the stems, the leaves, the sap, the bark of live plants, cold pressed or steam distilled into these highly concentrated aromatic compounds for their health benefits. So essential oils, when ancient cultures laboriously grew, harvested, and distilled these essential oils, they were not doing it because it smelled good. That is a side effect and we like it, but they really were using it for the therapeutic benefits for those health benefits, okay? So essential oils are very, very safe. There are virtually no side effects. Pregnant women, newborns can use them. There's no contraindication, so if you're on regular Western medicine or some herbs, you don't have to worry about things reacting. All essential oils are naturally antimicrobial. Did you know that? Most people don't know that. They kill pathogenic bacteria and they stop the growth of viruses. Okay? Lots and lots of tests, lots of peer-reviewed studies we can show you on that. Excuse me. Welcome everyone who joined us a little late. So they're very safe, they're naturally antimicrobial, and they affect our mood, right? When we take them, they affect our sense of smell, our olfactory system, and therefore our nervous system. So they work very, very quickly. So the essential oils that you have in your hands today are from a company, an American company called doTERRA. doTERRA means gift of the earth. That's exactly what these essential oils are, I believe, a gift from the earth, for sure. And not yet, wait. I know, it's good, but you gotta wait.
Sorry.
That's all right. So we're getting there, we're almost there. So doTERRA's been around almost about 7 years, and they've really set the bar on purity of therapeutic grade essential oils. There's really no pure, cleaner essential oils that you can buy in the world. So we're going to use them with a few breathing practices. And my hope really is that I'll give you a couple tools, simple tools that you can do anywhere, on a plane, in a car, waiting at the doctor's office, lying in bed when you can't fall asleep at night, okay? So why don't we, as best you can, let's clear our laps, but keep your essential oils maybe there or close by, put them in your pocket. We're gonna put both feet on the ground. It might be wise to scoot back in your chair a little bit so you can lean and sit up nice and tall. Good. And then you can take your hands just on your laps for now. And if you're comfortable with it, I'm going to invite you to close your eyes. If you don't want to close your eyes, that's fine. But closing our eyes just helps us move us away from our external world and bring us into that internal world a little bit. So let's together start with three grounding breaths. I like to begin this way. Let's take an inhale through our nose. Everyone inhale. Inhale, inhale. I want you to inhale more, more. It's the biggest breath you've taken all day. A little bit more. Hold it. Hold it. Keep holding it. Good, and you're going to let it out through the mouth. Close your lips. We're going to do that two more times. This will clear things up. Inhale through the nose. Inhale. Inhale. Little bit more. A little bit more. Fill up like a little balloon about to burst. What does that feel like? Hold it. Out through the mouth. All of it out, all of it out, all of it out. One more time. Through the nose, breathe into your chest. Breathe into your rib cage. Breathe into your belly. Breathe into your armpits. Breathe into your back. Hold it, last time, hold it. Very good. Out through the mouth. Good. Coughing's very normal, let it out. Nobody cares, just let it out, okay? Keep your eyes closed now, and now I'd like you to just, on your own, breathe in through your nose and breathe out through your nose. I want you to just find your natural breath this morning. I want you to create a relationship with your breath. How often do we do that? Next to never. How do you feel as that inhale comes into you? What do you feel move as that exhale goes out of you? Good, and to help us feel the shape change in our body a little bit, I'd like everyone to take your right hand and put it high up on your sternum above your heart. And I'd like you to take your left hand and put it down low on your abdomen. That's below your belly button. That's below your belly button, ladies. Good. Eyes are still closed if that's okay. And now I want you to ask yourself, what do I feel when I inhale? What moves in my hands? Does anything move in my right hand as I breathe in? Does anything move in my left hand as I breathe in? Good. What about the exhale? What moves in the right hand? The left hand? The space between the right and left hand? So you're just forming that relationship with your breath today. Good. I'm going to ask you to do one more thing before we break the oils out. I'd like you to inhale, and perhaps you feel a slight rise in your right hand and your chest when you do this, yes? At the top of that inhale, I want you to hold it for just a moment before you slowly exhale down into your left hand. Feel your belly muscles pull in just a little bit. And at the end of the exhale, I want you to wait for a moment before you start again. So you inhale, and you have a little pause at the top. And then you exhale all of it out slowly, and you have a little pause at the bottom. Inhale. There's a pause at the top. Exhale. There's a pause at the bottom. Three more times. This is called four-part breathing. And this is really what every breath is supposed to be. Every breath is supposed to have four parts. We just normally don't allow it to. Inhale, little pause at the top. Exhale all of it out. Little pause at the bottom. Very good. One more time. Good. When you finish this next exhale, keep your hands or keep your eyes closed for a moment, but let your hands come back in your lap. Just take a moment to savor the after effects of that breathing. What's a little different from when you walked in the room a few minutes ago? Good. And then just gently let your eyes flutter open. Is that nice? Is that nice to take a little moment to go inside, see what's there, get out of the chattery head and find that quieter voice inside of us? Even a couple of minutes, that's all it takes. So now we're going to take this, what in yoga we call pranayama, or this breath and energy practice, and we're going to use some essential oils. Very simple practices that you can do anywhere. So open up your little bags and find the wild orange. And you can go ahead and open it up. These little drams are very, very nice because they're quite tight, those orifice reducers on it. So the best way to do it is you're going to put a drop in your hand, one or two drops in your hand. So turn your dram over and give it a little tap with your finger, and you'll usually get a nice drop if you do that. So rather than shake, give it a little with your finger. Everyone getting a drop when they do that? Yeah? Okay, and so then you're going to rub your hands, one or two drops, your choice. So then you're going to rub your hands together. And now we're going to cup our noses. And we're going to take a couple deep breaths. Cup your nose, not your eyes. Couple deep breaths. Do we like that? See if you can take a four-part breath here. Take a big inhale. Hold at the top, if that's okay. Slow, slow exhale. Little pause at the bottom, maybe one more time. So what happens? There's an immediate effect, isn't there, when we smell that wild orange, right? It clears pathways, opens us up. It kills pathogens in the air. So it's great to when we're around a lot of people and it's, you know, cold and flu season. There's an immediate effect on our nervous system. Can you feel that? So wild orange is great for the skin, really great for the skin. Classically, it's used a little bit more like we used it today, which is to brighten emotions. To kind of create a very clear and alert mind, to give us a little boost of energy. Wild orange is actually a very, very special oil. Not many oils fall into this category. Wild orange is called adaptogenic. Have you heard that term maybe with other things? Meaning, whatever you need, it's gonna give you. So a lot of oils are stimulants, and a lot of oils are sedatives, and we'll kind of play with a few of those today. But wild orange is a very, very special oil. It's adaptogenic. If you need to go to sleep, it will help put you to sleep. But if you've got an hour-long drive, it'll give you that mental acuity and energy that you need to get home safely, right? Very, very special oil. So with that wild orange now fragranting ourselves and the room, I'm going to teach you another little breathing technique. We're going to do four-part breathing again, but I'm going to give you something more to do. Because sometimes when we're really agitated, we kind of need to busy the mind a little bit, or the mind will busy itself, right? Okay, so we're going to do a little trick in yoga called nyasa, and all nyasa means in Sanskrit is to place, and that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to take our thumbs and place them at the bottom of your pinky fingers. And you don't have to hold them up like I am, you can just go ahead and rest them on your thighs, okay? So now together on your next inhalation, let's try and all inhale together, and we're going to slide our thumbs up our pinky fingers. Go ahead, inhale. Slide your thumbs up your pinky finger, good. And now as you exhale, slide your thumbs down your pinky finger. Good. Take a moment and move to the ring finger. Same thing. Inhale, slide up. Exhale, slide back down. Good. Take a moment as you move to your middle finger now. Inhale, slide the fingers up. Exhale, slide back down. Try to use the nose if that's accessible to you today. And now the pointer finger. Inhale, slide up. Exhale, slide down. So it's just to give your mind something to do. If it's okay, close your eyes. Go back to your pinky fingers. We're going to do another round. Inhale. When you find your fingernail in the top of your inhale, hold for a beat. Then exhale, slide back down. There's a built-in pause as your thumb finds the ring fingers. Inhale, slide up. As you find the nail, hold. Exhale. Good. Find the middle finger, breathe in. Little pause, exhale. And the pointer finger, inhale. Hold and exhale. Bring your thumb back to the pinky finger. You're going to do one more round on your own, four more breaths. Let your inhale slide the thumb up and have a moment before you exhale and slide down. Try to use the nose if you can. Pinky or ring finger, inhale. Exhale. Middle finger. Pointer finger. Let your hands rest. Just take another breath or two here with the eyes closed. Again, see what that feels like in you. What's a little different? Good. And when you're ready, you can let the eyes open again. What do we think? Fun? Very easy technique to take with you. It's called Nyasa, but I have a friend who has two very young children who don't sleep very well, and she taught it to them before bed, and she calls it yoga fingers. And I like that. So yoga fingers, you can remember it. Very, very simple. You don't need to do both hands if you're driving. Trust me, there are many times I'm stuck on the 405 and just my right hand's going while my left hand's at the wheel, right? Okay. In bed, same thing, maybe just one hand as opposed to two. Very, very effective way to get that mind back in relationship with your breath, right? And find that little quieter spot inside of you. All right, so next oil, let's find the lavender. So we said that essential oils can, of course, be used aromatically. That's how we've used them so far. But they can also be used topically. So I'm going to invite you to use the lavender aromatically and topically if you want, which is open up your lavender, take two or even three drops, up to you, okay? Give it a little rub again, and then after you've taken it, well, actually, you could rub first. I invite you to rub it on your neck, chest, or back of the neck. Throat, chest, back of the neck, wherever you want. If you don't want to do that, you can do forearms. Forearms, a very popular place to put essential oils. After you've rubbed it in a little bit, then take a few deep breaths. So now you're using the essential oils two ways. You're getting the aromatic compounds into your lungs, and you're also getting it on your skin. Essential oils start to be absorbed within 30 seconds of either breathing or topical application. Do we like the lavender? Yeah, so a little bit different from the wild orange. So we've probably, most of us have had an experience with lavender before. What do we think of when we think of lavender? Yeah, so it's a soother, right? It's a soother. Lavender is exceptional for the skin, particularly irritated skin. So remember we said essential oils were naturally antibacterial. So a cut, right? A bee sting, an insect bite, it takes the sting out of things, a burn, a sunburn, right? It will help your skin heal much more quickly. It's great for rosacea, acne, eczema, really, really great oil for the skin. But of course, how else do we use it? It's calming, right? It's for anxiety, it's for stress, it's for helping us sleep. Yes? Everyone agree with that? So hopefully you won't go to sleep on me. That's why the peppermint comes last. Okay, but you can feel it's a little different from the wild orange, right? There's a calming that happens here. So since, raise your hand if you're not a champion sleeper. Right? Okay, me too. So my struggles with sleep just make me a better teacher and educator, and that's fine. But now I'm a pretty good sleeper, I've got to say. And these essential oils have been the game changer for me. But we can use a breathing technique as well. So when we want to calm ourselves down, so that's if we're angry, we're frustrated by somebody, we're feeling a lot of stress and anxiety, we can't go to sleep, what we like to do with yoga is emphasize the exhalations, okay? So we're going to work on making our exhales longer than our inhale. But I'm going to teach you another technique that you can or cannot do. It's up to you. I'll leave this one up to you, but it's very effective. So when we're going to make our exhales longer than our inhale, we're going to count. So one way to do that is in your head. Count in your head. One, two, three, four. Okay, and there's nothing wrong with that. That's how I started meditation back a gazillion years ago. It's a very effective technique. But there's another one that's a little more tactile, which is a different type of Nyasa. We did this kind of sliding Nyasa or yoga fingers. Now we're going to do a tapping one. So you got a thumb and you got four fingers. So what we're going to do is we're going to make our right hand represent our inhale. and our left hand represent our exhale. And so instead of counting to a count of four, one, two, three, four in my head, I'm gonna let my fingers do the counting. So I'm gonna inhale like this. And I'm gonna exhale like this. Do it with me, right hand. Inhale. Four, exhale. One, two, three, four. Inhale, two, inhale. Two, three, four.
Exhale. Two, three, four.
Inhale, two, three, four.
Exhale, two, three, four. Put your hands back in your lap.
Close your eyes if that's okay. Again, inhale, two, three, four.
Exhale, two, three, four. Inhale, two, three, four.
Exhale, two, three, four. Do one on your own.
Good.
Take a break. Now we're going to lengthen our exhalations. So when we exhale, it doesn't matter if you start with your pinky or your pointer, just be consistent. When you exhale, whatever finger you land on is going to get an extra tap. So now our inhale is going to stay four taps, 4 seconds about. Our exhale is going to be five. Okay, we're going to lengthen that exhalation. So take a little breath in and out. I'll talk you through the first one. Back to the right hand. Inhale,
two, three, four, left hand, exhale, two, three, four,
five. Inhale, two, three, four, exhale,
two, three, four, five.
Inhale, two, three, four, exhale,
two, three, four, five. Rest. Good.
One more time. Let's keep the inhale at four, but let's see if it's okay. Stay with five. Let's see if it's okay to take the, I know you're yawning. Yawning is your diaphragm resetting. It's not a bad thing. Let it happen, okay? Yawning is a good thing. So inhale for four. Let's try exhale for six.
One, two, three, four, five, go back the other way, six.
A really great breath to work up to at home, not today, is inhale for four, exhale for eight. That's a goal breath to have. Not today, it'll take a little while to work up. But let's see how six feels. Ready? Take a little breath in and out so we can start together. We're gonna go back to the right hand. Inhale, two, three,
four, left hand. Exhale, two, three, four, five, six.
Inhale, two, three, four.
Exhale, two, three, four, five, six.
Inhale, two, three, four. Exhale,
two, three, four, five, six. Do one on your own.
And one more. Let your fingers rest. Keep your eyes closed for a moment. Smell the lavender again if you want to. Mm-hmm. Again, what's changing in me? Yoga as its essence is a tool for transformation. The essential oils too. What's changing in me? And then let the eyes open. Do we like that? We feel like that's something we could maybe do at home? Whether we just need to
they tell moms, if you're really angry at your kids and you're about to yell at them, try and pretend like you chew a saltine cracker first before you say anything.
Have you guys heard that? Isn't that funny? I told you not to do that, right? Okay. So I try and do one of these breaths, inhale for four, exhale for six, right? I think it's a little bit better than mocking a saltine, which isn't good for you anyhow, right?
We are at a health conference after all.
All right, so lavender, nice, great. Okay, so now one more oil, one more application, as well as aromatic. Get the peppermint out.
No,
of course not. Of course not.
I didn't want to wake up.
I know. The number one request I get at my yoga studio is, when do we have sleepovers? Nobody wants to leave. Okay, so get the peppermint out. So I'm going to tell you a couple different ways to use this. So first is, can you smell it in the bottle? Those bottles, you may not smell them a lot, but peppermint's strong. Can you feel it smell a little bit in the bottle? Okay, so there's one. Number two is put a drop in your hand. Let's start with one. It's strong. Peppermint's strong. Smell, rub, put on the back of your neck. Peppermint very well absorbed in the back of the neck. I'm going to give you one other option if you want it. These essential oils are so pure and 100% clean that you can go ahead and take that bottle and take a drop in your mouth. Or if you want, it's your bottle, nobody else has touched it, you can lick the top. Plus it's all antimicrobial anyhow. See if you want to put a little bit in your mouth. So what do we know about this oil immediately? Woo! It's a stimulant, right? Definitely. Better than coffee, would you say? Yeah, it's definitely a breath freshener, right? So immediately, it creates a clear and alert mind, right? It wakes you up right away. Peppermint, just don't get them in your eyes, but definitely on the temples, back of your neck. Very, very cooling, yes? Those of us who have hot flashes, we just get hot because we live in Southern California. Very good for when you're hot, you're tired, you feel irritated, you feel stagnant, right? You have no motivation, you're apathetic, or you just can't find that last hour of work, you just don't think you can get through the day, right? Very, very powerful upper peppermint. What else do we know about peppermint is good for? Yes, all tummy discomfort. So you can take it internally, or you can actually, you don't even have to do that. You rub it right where the discomfort is, whether it's nausea or constipation or acid reflux is very, very good for too. Who's taken, remember when I said very highly concentrated aromatic compounds, these essential oils, right? So who's taken a cup of peppermint tea for an upset stomach, right? Nice, usually works, yes. Okay, so you would need to drink 28 cups of tea to get the effectiveness of the active constituents that are in that one drop you just put in your mouth. So when we say, you know, highly concentrated, we really mean it. That's why these little bottles are precious. They're not terribly expensive, but they'll last you a very, very long time. That's, you know, you're not going to be pouring a bottle down. Please don't do that, okay? So peppermint is this really nice clarifier and creates this alert mind and this nice energy. I can kind of see it in the room already. So let's do one more breathing technique. This is technically called the breath of relaxation, and I just think it's an overall balancer. Sometimes it's called the 4-7-8 breath, and I'll tell you why, well, you'll know why in a moment. But I really like this breath. Here's why I like this breath. It's because it's a very special old yogic technique that's finite, meaning you do it 8 times. That's it. You don't do it indefinitely, like the Niyasa or the four-part breathing that we were doing. You do it 8 times, no more, no less, 8 times, you're done. Okay? So sometimes if we're really agitated or we really need to focus, it's nice to have that number of like, I'm going to do this breath 8 times and then I'm done. There's something, again, kind of very clearing that happens with that, very grounding that happens with that. So it is also one of the very few times in yoga we're going to actually exhale out through our mouth. We don't do that very often, but we are. So here's what it is, and I'm going to do most of the counting today so you don't have to worry about staying too alert. I'll do most of the work for you. It's an inhale through the nose for 4 counts. Then we hold for 7. Then we exhale out through a little tiny opening in our lips, out through the mouth, for 8 seconds. So that's why it's called the 4-7-8 breath. Inhale for 4 through the nose, hold for 7, exhale for 8 out through the lips. Very, very slow, long exhale. We're gonna do 8 of them, no more, no less. I'll do the counting, you just have to do the breathing, okay? So just sitting up nice and tall, let's close the eyes again. Take a little breath in and out so we can all start together. Good. And here we go through the nose. Inhale. 2, 3, 4. Hold. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Through your lips now. Exhale. 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 Good. Through the nose. Inhale. Inhale, inhale, inhale. Hold, hold, hold,
hold, hold, hold through the lips. Exhale, 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 exhale.
Inhale, two, three, four. Hold,
two, three, four, five, six, seven, exhale.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
Inhale, two, three, four. Hold, two, three, four, five, six, seven, exhale.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
Inhale. Hold. Exhale.
Inhale. Hold.
Exhale. Good.
Inhale for four. Hold for seven. Exhale for eight.
And do one more on your own.
Let your breath go back to normal, keeping your eyes closed.
Let your breath resume its natural state again. See what that feels like.
Is that different from the beginning when you first watched your breath?
The great Lena Horne said, "It's not the burden that breaks you down, it's how you carry it." And so it's very easy in our very busy, full Western lives to forget that stress is not what happens to us. Stress is not what happens to us. Stress is how we react to what happens to us. And how we react is a choice.
And sometimes when we're feeling very, very stressed in life, we're just lacking the skills to deal with it better. And so I hope I've shared with you today some very real and concrete ways make that burden feel a little lighter. Yes? Things that you can take with you wherever you go, either the breathing or the essential oils, or hopefully both. Okay? So I think we're good on time, right? I think we have a couple minutes, but I can take a few questions. Yeah, like two or three if you want. My team, a couple things before you go. My team is in the exhibitor section right in the middle. Just follow the beautiful smells you're so familiar with now. We'll be there all day till 3 o'clock. We'd love to see you, answer some questions about health concerns you might have or things you're looking for to alleviate in your life or feel better in your life, and suggest some oils to them. Help you get these oils into your home if you're looking to do that today. It's very, very simple. And Alyssa and Amy also have some team events, some more training in essential oils from about Pasadena to Claremont over the next 4 weeks. Most of the events are free. You're all welcome to always attend. There's lots of contact information. But while you're here today, during lunch or during one of the breaks, please come down to the booth and say hi and let us know how we can help you further. Okay? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Have a great rest of your day. Namaste.